Hello, my lovelies. Welcome to my channel. Here we are doing the middle of the month love readings. This is going to be for Cancer, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Let's get right into your reading, Cancer. Let's see what Spirit has for you guys for this month. Now, your first card here is the Five of Swords. We have the Four of Swords, the King of Swords. Wow, a lot of swords here, you guys. The Seven of Pentacles and the Two of Cups. Okay. All right, Cancers. I see you guys being extremely guarded. It's important that for the remaining of the month, not to vibrate from a frequency of ego. Because there is like a humbling experience that you're currently dealing with or currently going through. For some of you guys, this is self-reflective. For others of you, there is some type of conclusion, some type of, it's like a temporary situation where there is a lot of self-reflection that needs to happen. With the Five of Swords, it's like we're combative, we are aggressive even, because we feel like we don't want to allow other people to belittle us. We don't want other people to see us as we failed at a relationship or some type of connection here. But it's ego-based. So what they're telling you is, don't grow fond of the need to have to prove yourself, Cancer. It's almost like there is a need for you to stop worrying or stop comparing yourself to your friends, to your family members, to your loved ones, to people around you. It's almost like what I'm hearing is almost like, well, all my friends are settled. Why can't I settle? Or all my friends are in happy relationships. Why is it so difficult for me to find a happy relationship? What they're telling you is you're vibrating from an ego-based. And I assure you that even the relationships that seem to be perfect are never perfect. And that is a fact. So the moment you stop comparing, or the moment you stop almost like, what's the word I'm looking for? It's almost like a feeling of comparing, but it's more like glorifying something that is not, it's only superficial. It's not really what it is. So there is a need for you to come down to reality when we're talking about relationships, when we're talking about partnerships. There's no relationship that is perfect. It takes effort on both sides. And ultimately, it comes down to finding the person that finds your virtues and flaws and is able to work with that in perfect harmony. It's almost like you're bringing them the balance of what they lack. It's like a mirror. Whatever it is that they lack, you probably overpossess. And that's something that they learn from you, and you feed them that, and they feed you the same in turn. Do you see what I'm saying? So it's about being patient. It's about not rushing things because you feel that at this point you should be settled. They're telling you, like, don't do that. There is a need to be grounded in what it is exactly that you want when we're talking about relationships. Now, the Four of Swords indicates to me the partner being detached, or the partner that you were dealing with at some point created some type of distancing. Because they, you know, they're emotionally not available. They've emotionally checked out. And with the King of Swords here, this is indicating the connection or dynamic of the relationship. And the King of Swords is the least king to be emotional. This is about being methodical. This is about being in your head and analyzing. So it could have been that you were overly emotional and dealing with someone that was emotionally not available. And perhaps you had hopes and ideals and, you know, aspirations that at some point they would open up. But with the King of Swords, this is a person that is not fully in it, because they gravitate more towards being analytical. And if they felt like with the Five of Swords, if they felt like you were overly emotional or you would react in a certain way, it could have been what triggered them to create that distancing, that pulling away. What they're showing me here, the advice is the Seven of Pentacles. So this is indicating to me, it's time for you to look at your past, Cancer, and really reflect on the mistakes we've done. Because there is like a recurring cycle here is what they're showing me. And in order for you to fully embrace this new beginning that's coming towards you, this Two of Cups, this unconditional love, this true connection, genuine and authentic love for each other, in order for you to be able to embrace that or even draw that into your life, you need to acknowledge the mistakes you've made in the past and you continuously keep making. So there is a need for self-growth here, but it's the maturity of emotions. Are you the type that when you're being tested or when you feel like you're losing control, you kind of go on this spiral effect of just being completely impulsive and overly emotional that you get to the point of disrespecting your partner? Do you try to manipulate certain situations because you're vibrating from a place of fear? The fear of losing the partner, the fear of seeing how they're growing cold, that type of energy. And what they're telling you is if you are doing this, there is a need for you to acknowledge why you're doing it, to acknowledge why we keep going on this cycle that we've needed at some point to grow past, to be able to fully embrace a loving, authentic connection. All right, my lovelies, I hope that this gives you insight, understanding, wisdom, and knowledge, and we'll see each other soon. Bye.